Saul kept on threatening to kill the Lord's followers. He even went to the high priest and asked for letters to the leaders of the synagogues in Damascus. He did this because he wanted to arrest and take to Jerusalem any man or woman who had accepted the Lord's way. When Saul had almost reached Damascus, a bright light from heaven suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying, "Saul, Saul, why are you so cruel to me?" "Who are you?" Saul asked. "I am Jesus," the Lord answered. "I am the one you are so cruel to. Now get up and go into the city, where you will be told what to do." Those words come from Acts chapter 9, verses 1 to 6. Saul was seeking to please God and to do the things that were right in the eyes of the Lord. But Saul tried to please the Lord by killing those who were pleasing God. His heart was right, but his actions were all wrong. Saul reminds me today of those who want to kill Christians in order to please God. You know who they are, and you know that like Saul, they are very serious about what they believe, even though they are wrong. The answer for Saul was to see a vision and hear the voice of the Lord on the road to Damascus. Then Saul came to know that opposing Jesus did not please God. The problem was that anyone who would come to Saul to tell him about Jesus would be the target of Saul's rage. So God met Saul on the road and turned Saul's life around. Then, the one who was the most feared by followers of Jesus because he wanted to kill them became the Apostle Paul and carried the message of Christ to everyone he met. Could it be that those who today want to kill followers of Jesus also will have a vision of Jesus on the road they are traveling? If so, it may certainly be that those we fear the most may become God's instruments for the next worldwide revival. So when you meet or even hear of someone who wants to kill you because you follow Jesus, remember that God can change their heart into another Apostle Paul. Remember that when you pray for your enemies. Lord Jesus, thank you for meeting Saul on the road to Damascus. I pray, Jesus, that you will meet more of your enemies even today, so they too can join with all your children in praising your holy name. Amen.